Okay, I probably had a deal on it.
I'm a manager type shit.
So like, can you like get ready? Can you go notes? Like, can you see yourself right there?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Alright, so you can't do it. You know what I'm saying?
So yeah, man, what's this you offer me like some tea, bro? What's this you're sipping on right here?
Yeah, this is alkaline water. This ain't nothing but lemons, distilled water, turmeric, and cinnamon. That's supposed to like alkalize the body and like clean all that excess shit you've been eating.
Really?
And keep your shit fluid. You got copper minerals in here, so it'll keep your blood flowing and shit. And it's like that, I call it boat juice because I drink this and I go outside and meditate. You know what I'm saying? Get that sunlight. That's pretty much why I made it, because you're like photosynthesize yourself when you drink it.
Wow.
You
mix with the sun.
Yeah, yeah. Super Saiyan shit.
That's tight, bro. Super Saiyan.
Super Saiyan. Okay. You got the trench and you be feeling yourself, feel that sunlight hit your skin, melanin be popping, doing handstands.
Yeah, man. I be seeing that on your Instagram. You know, the type of things you put inside your body, you know what I'm saying? You be monitoring that pretty good.
Yeah, I'm real like health conscious and vegan, you know, so I don't really get too much bullshit and just trying to use my mind before I eat and all that kind of stuff.
For sure. So real, how's that translate to the tunes though, man? Like, you be doing that with your beats, or do you do that to inspire music?
Yeah, I try to, when I make beats, I try to like come at a different angle than like most hip-hop bass producers would, you know what I'm saying? I'll probably go listen to like a different genre of music, like some UK shit, or I'll listen to some old Bob Marley, and then I'll get the sonics from that, and then I'll get inspired by that, and then I'll approach it like I approach that, you know what I'm saying? Not the basic three-piece chord over the drums, you know, I don't want like full production, just some cool creative shit, you know?
Yeah, your beats come out cool, man. I know you kind of custom make them for yourself, but do you be giving them to other people?
Not really yet though. I really want to. Like, I want to start producing for James and just handing beats out on the low. And that's what I'm working on this summer. I'm trying to learn to play the piano, fuck with the FL shit, master that shit. And once I get good enough, I start sliding niggas on the side. You know, I'm trying to come in from that angle. But yeah, shit, all right.
Thanks for, you know, copping some gear, man.
Oh, man.
What was you saying though? You had a dream?
I had an epiphany. It was like some futuristic shit. I was in here daydreaming about future shit, future success. Like, I'm pretty sure all artists do.
Sure.
And I just was thinking heavily on the Memphis community, and like, I was thinking about us in the future. And I just remember like pulling up to the function, and I just had like Product of Memphis on. Like, I was really, because that shirt you gave me one time had this M on it, and then I seen you've been working. And I was like, really going somewhere with this, and this could be like a real staple for the community. And then I just instantly saw myself pulling up with the shirt on, and you niggas been like, yo, okay, I see you. And then you in the pictures, niggas been like, okay, I see you. Just trying to keep it in the community, you know. Like, we all got power.
Yeah, for sure, because you were mentioning too, maybe off camera, you were talking about right now you don't have no clothes.
Nah,
so you're trying to like buy as much everybody's community stuff as you can right now.
Yeah, I just want to rebrand myself as a Memphis artist from head to toe, you know what I'm saying? So I just want to like touch bases. Like, I got this from Keyshawna, who does a nice Christmas service.
Nice piece, right?
And just like next level shit like this, you know what I'm saying? This is an amazing idea, and I just want to like support all of that shit, because like, it's like a paradigm. We all support each other, you know?
So you be St. Pablo right here, man. Did you go to the concert?
Yeah.
What'd you think about like the, I didn't go, man. What'd you think about like the floor in the middle of the air?
It was like next level. Like, I've been to a lot of shows, and I haven't seen no one do it like him. Like, yeah, I mean, I don't know. I had fun. Like, she was awesome.
Dope, man.
Yeah.
So, like, real quick about, like, shows, my man, like,
yeah,
clearly, like, people like dope shows where you be having dope stuff in it. Like, what do you think about adding that to, like, your performance? Like, have you thought about, like, doing different stuff like that?
Yeah, I definitely want to add a lot of props and get more into the indie scene and away from, like, the so-called rap scene. Because, like, I know a lot of artists, like Travis, and just a whole bunch of artists in general have, like, props. And it's, like, they just add pieces of their imagination onto the stage. And it's more of, like, a play in a way. It's, like, performance art. So it's kind of, like, how come a lot more artists aren't doing that? But I understand it's a money thing, but still, like, I've been thinking about adding that kind of shit. Like, probably not budgeting for a screen right now, like Kanye type shit.
Yeah.
Probably just like some smoke screens and just lights. And just like
different hints, like you said, yeah, pieces of the imagination.
Yeah.
Stuff that is in your song, maybe, or hints in your song.
Yeah. I want to do like live human props, and they just be standing still, like statues, and I just be going around them type shit, and they just turn it into a whole, like, St. Pablo experience, you know what I'm saying? Because it's like, that's where it's going right now. Like, these major artists are like setting the foundation for us to like follow behind. And like, the niggas is on that shit, gonna pick it up. You know what I'm saying? I know a lot more artists say they wanna do this and this and that. And so, and I know a lot of bands just get creative. Like, I went and saw, what's that band called? I saw this band in Hightone and,
some recent.
No, it wasn't recent. It was like,
Yeah,
and they had the lights. Like, in Hightone, nobody ever uses props, so they had the
lights.
Was
it the feminine show? The hobby show?
No, I forgot. Space Phase. You know that band?
Space Phase. That's Jacob,
bro. Them niggas had all this shit on the background. They had lights. They had walls. I walked into that bitch. I was like, what the fuck? I was like, that is next level performance shit, like, for live artists, like, you know, get to the next level, this is what you have to do, like, just taking aware of that shit.
Sure, man, yeah, I like that too, it makes more of an experience for me. Especially, you know what I'm saying, spend some dough.
Yeah, you gotta invest in that shit, but it's worth it though. It's like, I guess, for me and the artist, that's all coming along with just me making music, you know what I'm saying? I don't wanna just make the music, I wanna, like, perform that shit to you, like, give you that experience. And then build a legacy off that, you know what I'm saying? And then shit like that.
What else is gonna come from that? I think that's pretty much good right there, bro. The interview.
Oh, yeah, that's straight.
Yeah, that's straight.
It's really nappy to say, man. Would you get that album?
Yeah, from Amazon. It's really for this camera right here, but